you for the kind introduction. Climate change is no longer what it is. It is the new normal. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Benjamina Flor of the University of the Las Banas College of Development Communication. This afternoon, I'll be presenting to you a paper that I presented in Beppu. It's the Ritsumeikan University in Japan. And I would like to take this opportunity to thank SEARCA for sponsoring my participation in the conference. And I also would like to acknowledge the presence of my co-authors. We have Ms. Julie Rupela. My paper is entitled Exploring the Potentials of Community Media for Climate Change Resilience Through Social Transformation Towards the New Normal in the Asia-Pacific Region. This study was also funded by UP Los Baños, Office of Research and Extension. This study is premised on the basis that in the Asia-Pacific region, the Philippines is one of the most vulnerable to disasters because it sits along a typhoon belt and a so-called ring of fire where many of the earthquakes and volcanic eruptions occur. Coupled with its coastline elevation, it is prone to storm surge and tsunamis. How should this be communicated to every Maria and Juan? 2 years ago, Haiyan or Typhoon Yolanda struck Leyte, and everything else is history. In January 2013, there was a threat of a tsunami, and people fled their homes for safer grounds and left everything that they had. Pigs, refrigerator, sofa, etc. Simple belongings, perhaps, but diamonds to the poor. Just like the boy and bride group, they did not leave their homes when Haiyan hit them. As a compromise, fathers and their sons guarded their homes. How do we make them climate change resilient? Should we want this to happen again? The response? Social transformation for community media. It's specifically community radio. However, community radios thrive on volunteerism. Addressing environmental concerns requires sustainability, environment being complex in itself. Thus, the objectives of this study are identify factors for a sustainable community radio station, assess existing system of operation, and develop a community radio station model that will ensure sustainability. In essence, we would like to find out what CRS model can best fit to respond to the new normal and for radio stations to go beyond their usual functions of information, entertainment, and education. Participation of people is now mandatory to save their lives and the future generation. And why social transformation? Because we need to transform norms about the new normal in order to have desired behavior. Transformational communication model forwards that environmental communication requires a more comprehensive and holistic paradigm. The transformational communication model is an integration of four major components or modes applied to development undertakings representing development support communication, information education communication, social marketing, and social mobilization. It also involves the inclusion of the cultural dimension. It provides an imaginary line that takes into account the cultural dimension and these approaches. It focuses on normative instead of behavioral change because in the environmental field, there there are various friendly and non-friendly environmental behaviors that may be identified, but the list could be endless. This integrative operational framework for climate change resilience focuses on social mobilization. What is social mobilization? Welcome to OAIT. Social mobilization is bringing together all stakeholders, and I mean everyone, to raise people's awareness of the demand for a particular development program. Social mobilization assists in the delivery of resources and services and strengthens community participation for sustainability and self-reliance. It is an act of rallying together as many social allies, like government leaders, non-government organizations, civil society, and business sector, to own and support a certain development program through a platform, and in this case, community radio. Social mobilization has six components. We have advocacy, IEC, community organizing, capability building, monitoring, evaluation, networking, and alliance building. The idea is for communities to find a champion, a leader who will lead them in mainstreaming environmental concerns on a continuing basis. Massive education and the new normal must be carried out. Communities must be organized, people trained, with participatory monitoring evaluation system embedded in the process. By expanding the network to other information sources, up-to-date reporting can be done, partnering with relevant information agencies like those in Japan or in the USA, PAGASA, PBOX, Climate Change Commission, DNR, and the like, can increase awareness on what needs to be done. Socially preparing the people before the event is crucial. And why community radio? Community radios are FM low-powered radio stations manned by the community, ideally. In Thailand, for instance, there are 3,000 community radio stations in the FM band. These stations require a two-way process where there is an exchange of views and the adaptation of media by communities. Community radios allow members of a community to gain access to information, entertainment, and education, and participation. It is a medium where communities participate as planners, producers, and performers. It is the means of expression of the community rather than for the community. In the context of the Philippines, the most potent community media tools are community radio, plus, can you guess, my phone, plus, fire chat. My phone, the cheapest phone in the Philippines, has a built-in FM radio, which can access the nearest radio signal. Farmers use this for entertainment and information access. FireChat can be installed as a free app that works through Bluetooth, even without electricity. Disaster alerts can be sent to these apps to call people to action. At present, existing models of community radio station in the Philippines include ACADEM, National Government Local Government Partnership of DSMQ, the Sindaco Oriental State College of Science and Technology, Public ACADEM Partnership, or DXDL, that's in the University of Southern Mindanao. ACADEM LG Partnerships, DWTG and DWRL at Cagayan State University. Religious Economical Private Partnership, or DYMY in Iloilo. And LG Private Partnership in UIMM, also in Iloilo. While the first and the third are non-profit, the second and the last two are profit-oriented. They air commercials for sustainability. AMARC defines CRS as non-profit, but it doesn't mean that they can't air commercials. AMARC is an international non-government organization serving the community radio movement with almost 4,000 members and associates in 130 countries. Its goal is to support and contribute to the development of community and participatory radio along the principles of solidarity and integrated cooperation. To survive, they need resources because CRS play facilitative and catalytic roles in social transformation processes. They set social agenda, facilitate governance communication, enable changes in norms, and move people to action. While putting up a radio station is a challenge for local government units, this is no cost for alarm because, based on the local government code, LGUs as stated in Chapter 2, Section 17 and 23, shall provide basic services and facilities, including telecommunication services, subject, of course, to national policies and guidelines. And they have the authority to negotiate and secure grants or donations in support of these basic services from local or foreign assistance agencies. The proposed community radio station model, based on the results of the study, could thus be in the following criteria. CRS must ensure that the objective is to mainstream social processes that involve education, collective pressures, and shifting people's worldview, attitudes, and values towards climate change resilience. CRS must be fully funded either by public or private. It must have a flat organization with lean staff, that means very few people. Probably your anchor, your radio station manager, a technician, and field reporter. The Community Radio Council of the Philippine Federation of Rural Broadcasters must be actively involved in its operation. For them to work collaboratively with relevant agencies for networking and information access through information communication technologies, including AEC or ASEAN Economic Community Plus 3, which includes Japan, Korea, and China. Programming must be localized and relevant contents because for climate change, these events are in situ. These are on a case-to-case basis, so you cannot have a uniform or a standard adaptation strategies for every locality. And municipalities without a community radio station must have one, especially those in vulnerable areas. And station managers are mandated to engage the community into action. In conclusion, CRS, to be sustainable, must have a lean organizational structure with ample support from the local government unit. The church, the private companies or public organization to sustain its operations. It should be complemented by worthy and relevant contents that responds to community needs, since climate changes are case-to-case basis. Localized programming to sustain matters or to discuss things that matter. Finally, CRS as the last mile linkage in times of disaster may be the only resort to save people's lives. Thank you.
That was great questions. Thank you very much, Dr. Flor. That's a very interesting presentation on the proposed model for community radio stations that could perhaps increase the resilience of communities.
Questions? I have my co-researcher with me to answer the question.
Yes, the floor is now open for questions, comments, insights from the audience. Anyone? Nineteen and one.
Yes.
Okay. Can I identify yourself?
I'm Nicole. I am an undergraduate of DevCom. And my question is there a locality that has already used a CRS during a time of disaster or calamity?
Actually, these stations have already done their part on that. And these stations that we visited are in Iloilo and in Cagayan. And we make understand that there are more stations that have been doing the same, except that we have not visited them. But for a community radio station in its purest sense, like being run by the community, managed by the community, it's kind of absent. So there was this project by Danida and their Dr. Louis Tabin. There were like a number of them all over the Philippines. So we have like 80 or 25 community radio stations all over, from Batangas to Bulacan, and not one of them survived as a pure community radio station as defined by AMARC. That's why the proposal based on these results would be for the local government units to take on the catch-up. Kasi hindi talaga siya mabubuhay kung siya lang. It thrives on volunteerism. So imagine if you are to manage a station for 2 hours, three hours, and then tomorrow you're not there. Next day you are there. So what will happen to your listeners? They thrive on donations, on siguro, on take-on-take from Jollibee or from Magdo, or you could not even mention their products. Ano lang, these hours brought to you by McDonald's. Magagalula. Especially steam products, no? Like alcohol and cigarettes. The more they cannot air commercials. But these two stations that I mentioned earlier on are thriving on commercials. And they partnered with Radyong Bayan and Radyo Natin, Manila Broadcasting Company. So they have a share of the profits. One radio station earns like 200,000 pesos a month, which would maintain a lead structure. A station manager, an anchor person, a reporter, and a technician. For a radio station to operate, you need to have a licensed operation technician. So the operation technician normally would come from the LGU, so he takes care of the electrical, electronic communication requirements like LGU and doubles up as technician of the radio station. And so far, most of them will be able to participate or do their jobs in the LGU if the mayor is a leader. So it would be better if we have a lead staff that could run the daily operations of a community radio station. But the purpose here is, I think, beyond information dissemination. It is really more of socially preparing the communities in times of disasters like this. With the new normal, we will experience stronger typhoons. We will experience stronger earthquakes, baha and all. And how do we educate the people in these areas? Like what happened to Leyte, nobody took on a warning. So what happened to them? Ngayon, puro byuda ang nasa Leyte. Because all their husbands and their children, male, child, that is, were all gone. So kailan pa ba natin, naantay pa ba natin mangyari kundi yun? So my proposal is to take advantage of community radio station as the last line linkage. And right now, we're doing a study funded by the East Asia Development Network, where we will benchmark practices in Thailand and in Vietnam. And maybe some more community radio stations in the Philippines that solely address this particular concern. I understand people have one, and unfortunately, the program is no longer on. So they had some problems in terms of sustainability. So if it's not funded by the local government unit, the station will not survive. Especially that the National Telecommunication Commission is very strict in terms of the scope of reach. So if you're a community radio station, you're limited to 1 kilowatt, probably the the highest wattage would be 3 kilowatt. That means 3 kilowatt would be around 30 kilometer radius. That would be the range. And it depends on what kind of frequency you will be given. Normally, the frequency would be FM. At saka yung FM, it's not... Ayaw namin yung FM, sabihin ng LGUs. Bakit? Ayaw namin English-English. Bakit English-English? Pero usapan natin dito, frequency, no? It's not the format of the program. Because FM is synonymous to DJ, di ba? Ito po yung radio station. Need not necessarily be. Pero, in some cases, these FM stations could have programs like those. But also, they have black timers, like DNR or DOH or DEPED. And at least we have one sana for the RRN. Something that people should be prepared for. Other than reporting on, may bagyo bukas, or may sisilidong, would announce. Like, you're telling me the threat, but you cannot tell me the risk. You cannot compute the risk. So, di ba tayo, panic. So, what do we do? Bahala na lang. Ako, pag lumindol, wala na lang mga nanesang ganito, nanesang yung glass. Nakipatay na lang. Parang si Duterte. Patay kung patay. Kasi, wala eh, di ba? Eh, pwede bang ganun? Pwede bang kailangan bantay ang iyong mga baboy at iyong mga manok? Hindi pwede. Sabi natin, collective pressure. Kasi alam mo na lang mangyayari. And how will it happen? Without preparation. Dapat yung mga evacuation centers natin would have energy bars. Kasi magbibigay ka ng bigas, magbibigay ka ng noodles, mga panluto. Labasan ka natang posporo. O, mga energy bars na, ano yan, coconut? O kaya, ano pa mga energy bar? Ma-invento natin, no? Maka mga mango energy bars. Mga frozen season, we could package them into to energy bars na parang saan lang? Sa spacecraft. Pakikain ng mga ton. To at least address a week maybe or a few days in the evacuation center. Pagdating natin sa evacuation center, the more we get sick, walang banyo, walang sitero, walang, ano yun? Evacuation center na hindi naman talaga siya prepared to help people. Sana may mahanap kami. Actually, naghahanap lang kami. We're going back to Cagayan, and there's this one program, kaya lang election time na. So, medyo, at saka napakainit. Heat index like 51, Cagayan. So, imagine. Marami na sa age ko. Mas bata pa lang.
Ma'am, yung kung DZLP is it considered to be a community radio station? Yung sa amin yun, no?
Yeah. Actually, no. It's a community development broadcasting station. Kasi yung community radio is characterized or defined by the boundaries or reach. But Amar could say, regardless of the nature of or type of a station, whether it be AM or FM, whether it's 1 kilowatt, 2 kilowatt, or 3 kilowatt, if it's something that is being run by a particular group, then it can be a community radio station. So, kung ito ay LGBT radio station, hindi community radio siya for the LGBT community. But DZLB is a development broadcasting station. So, we talk about development-oriented programs. So, ang mga news namin, hindi pwede yung mga may pinatay, may nirape. Hindi pwede yung gano'n. Hindi pwede sensationalize. It has to be development-oriented issues only. So we talk about sustainable development goals, boring, no? We talk about, sino makikinig doon? Yung na nga sinasabi natin, it's not sino makikinig, but you have to make pakinig, and you have to participate in the development of the program if you want to survive. So yun na yun, we transform the norms. We cannot assume that people will change. No? Well, this is a debate in DEPCO, that we want to change people's behaviors. Actually, we cannot. We change the norms. If you can change the norms, behavior, hopefully, will follow. Yung mga tatakaran, yung mga practices, kahit na pagkatapunan ng basura, Now, if you've not been trained to keep your basura in your pockets or keep it at home, then you will always be throwing your basura like any others. Sabi ko, bakit Singapore? Pilipino din naman yun nandun. Bakit hindi nagtatapon? Di ba, Shane? Sa MRT, no? MRT, nakalagay, $500 fine for eating. Ito naman si Dr. Flor. Mayroon, cheap. $500! Yes! $500 pala. Kung may babayad ka, eh, paano mo lang ibayad? O kaya, weeping, 30 canes, in public, gusto mo ba yan? Well, palagay ko talagang ginagawa nila. Di ba? To discipline. Bakit it's about time? It's about time that we do something like that. To be more empathic and to be more participative in these kinds of events. Baka yun lang ang makakapag-prepare ka sa atin socially. Any other question? Yes?
Mommy, you said that the most vulnerable to climate change are the rural people, the ones who are really poor. Now, when we talk about community radio stations, and then you said that we need to, it has to be participatory, meaning it's inclusive, it must include everyone. So does that mean na yung po mga mahihirap, paano po sila, sinasabi yung kanina, meron dapat may cellphone, kaya may technical dapat may radio. So kung poor siya and he cannot even afford to buy a cellphone, so paano po yung model na yun?
GSM.
GSM.
Alam mo yung GSM? Dahil sa loob na naman. Hindi, joke lang. Hindi. Actually, yung Maslow's hierarchy of needs, din bank na yun eh. Hindi na daw food ang basic need.
Self-card.
So, ibig sabihin, meron kang gadget. Kasi it's a necessity nowadays. And in many communities, nakita namin ito first time. We saw farmers talaga, may dala silang cellphone for music, for entertainment. And there is this one community in Santa Rita, Cagayan, where the only station that you could access is the local station. So even if the station has no anchor person, basta may music, 24 hours, alam nila, yun yun. So the mayor, the information officer, or the station manager would make some announcements. Oh, nandito na yung mga check-in ninyo. Pwede na pick-upin. Oh, nandito na yung mga yero for the rehab ng mga bahay. Pwede na pick-upin. So, alam nila na yun yung station. And the mayor was so passionate about the station. So, they coordinated with the alternative learning school, or learning ALS system of DepEd to offer elementary and high school programs through ALS using radio. Eh, ngayon wala, wala kang radio. O, ito, radio. Bili ka ng radio, please. And then you have no reason why you cannot listen to radio. Kung wala kang baterya, o, bili ka ng baterya. Kasi it's collective action. Then it has to be fully supported by all concerned. Open naman yung mga communities. They want to be listening to their voices on air. Iba ang sila, say, they make poems, they sing on the air, they encourage their neighbors to listen kasi feature sila. May mga school on air program sila. And I think these are very rich experiences. But I think it's not, again, it's not for all kinds of communities. But for the vulnerable ones, I think this kind of model will work. Basta may support.
Part of the local
government. Actually, it's also one of the recommendations that we offered to the Philippine Climate Change Adaptation Project.
Africa.
Baka pag nag-face to daw, Wilmer was so happy about his soft mode and the radio part. So baka lang, no guarantees that it will come to fruition, but I think it will happen.
Thank you.
Yes, I am.
Yes, I am.
Do you plan on testing the model or your conclusion to other community radio stations? Yeah. Kasi po, di ba, nasa isang area lang kayo. So, mm-hmm. How about other vulnerable areas in the Philippines? Do you plan to test it on a, para mag full-blown siya into a national scale?
Mm-hmm. Actually, it's already upscale. We're now doing the same study under East Asia Development Network. So, EADN. It's funded by EADN. That's managed by EADS of UPLB. So, nag-scale up na siya. Kasi for the university daw to be developing a niche, then you have to build on your research. So, the first step is this step. The second step will be EADN. And upscaling further would be SEARCA. So, the dami ng station natin. Hopefully it will happen. Kasi, off the record, ang NTC, ewan ko lang ako, true, 300,000 daw to get a frequency. Walang resibo. Kaya walang number na available. Pero may 300 ka, may available. Hindi alam ng LGUs, they were so surprised that we have this chapter 2, section 17 and 23, that they are authorized to have their own telecommunication services. So ngayon, medyo mayaman yung LGU. Yung isang LGU pinuntahan namin with the university, ayaw niya mag-partner sa university. Kasi hindi naman daw, pala niya kailangan ang university to have a license. Kasi pag educational radio, it's easier to get a franchise for frequency. So medyo nasira ko yung relationship. But again, I think the plus factor for collaborating with the universities is content. So the universities will have content. And imagine if we could tap pag-asa Project Noah. Project Noah is complaining, or rather, hindi na complaining, worried lang, why they cannot disseminate their information, their results, as they would have wanted to. Kasi nobody can popularize their results. Eh, depok yun. So yung mga depok dapat, yun ang work. That we need to help in the popularization. So if we could duplicate Kuya Kim in every community, ano yung tawag? Si Kuya ano? Si Kuya Kim o si Ate Kim? Ate Kim Mai? The likes of Kuya Kim. Kasi when we had this survey, they identified Kuya Kim to be a credible source of environmental issues. O kaya ang mga matanglawin, maparami natin mga demoklasing program. But of course, there's one study that we, as a master's student did, and this is one of the biggest networks, the government biggest network, siya doon, guess who? And she interviewed the news, the vice president in operations, and apparently, sabi na, ay naku, walang makikinig dyan. Sayang lang ang effort natin dyan. Walang makikinig. Hindi yan interesado. And this student was not satisfied with the response of the boss, so she conducted a survey, random, along Baseco, coastal area ng Manila. Out of 189 respondents, 90% would want to have this kind of program. And that's over national radio station. Kasi kailangan na eh. Sensitized tayo. New normal na eh. Cannot be business as usual. So we have to prepare. Raise ourselves for upcoming events that we do not know when will it strike or if it will ever strike. Kaya kami sa tuntung eh. We had the first baha, like baha talaga, in 1996. We had the second one in 2006. And it's like 2016. Anytime! Magbabangka na naman kami sa walang daga. Ganun na lang ba? Ganun na lang ba talaga yun? And we have to do something. Anything else? master's thesis on community radio, by the way. Now, this student conducted a study in Cagayan as well on participatory radio program planning. And he investigated both public and private stations, radio stations, and most of them would want to have a participatory radio. But you are gonna sana you will all there.
Okay,